Hello students, today we will start the new chapter, that is structure of atom. Structure of atom means actually what is the structure of the atom, that means what are the subatomic particles are present inside the atom. You know that according to Dalton atomic theory, atom is indivisible particle. That means atom neither be created nor be destroyed, it is further not divisible. But in this chapter, we will discuss the various subatomic particles. That means what are the subatomic particles present inside the atom. Mainly those are, you know that little bit, electron, neutron, proton, etc. Electron is negatively charged, we will discuss it later on. Okay, electron is negatively charged, who discovered this, everything. And the various atomic structure as well as isotopes and isobars and their applications. It's okay? So, according to Dalton atomic theory, atom is indivisible particle, but later on various scientists discover various subatomic particle. But my question is, what gives the scientists to discover the various subatomic particle? Let me give you an example. You know that each and every substance are electrically neutral. When you rub a glass rod with silk, you know that glass rod acquires positive charge, but silk acquire negative charge. Why this thing happen? Actually, in electricity chapter, I have discussed number of questions like this. Which substance get positive charge? Which substance get negative charge? So listen, when any substance lose electron, that means it has proton dominated, means more protons are there. That means it acquire positive charge. When any substance gain electron, in that case, it acquire negative charge. So, why a substance get positive charge, get negative charge? For this concept, mainly scientists try to find which are the subatomic particles are there inside the atom, due to which these substances are get positive or negative charge. So, later on, various scientists discover the subatomic particles like electron, proton and neutron. It's okay? So, subatomic particles are, one is electron, second one, proton, third one, neutron. So, who discovered this, what is their charge, how they are present, this thing we have to discuss. So, first one we'll discuss, that is electron. So, this is the subatomic particle which contain negative charge. So, it is discovered by J.J. Thomson. Proton is discovered by E. Goldstein and neutron is discovered by James Chadwick. First, we'll discuss how the electron is discovered. Electron is discovered by J.J. Thomson, but at that time, James Crookes was experimented about the cathode ray tube, that means the discharge tubes. One concept is there you will learn in higher classes, that is work function. If you apply high voltage to any substance, it start emitting electrons. This gives the scintillation if you perform this experiment in a discharge tube. That means in a tube, you make it vacuum. So this is gas ejected or compressor is used. Here one cathode, here one anode. How you know that this is cathode, this is anode? So simply just observe here, this is the negative, this is the positive. If you join this, the electrode which joined to negative part is cathode and the electrode which joined to the positive part, it is anode. At high voltage, that means if you apply 10,000 volt here and this tube is vacuum, in that case you will notice that the rays are emitted from cathode, which is known as cathode ray. Since the rays are emitted from cathode and moves towards anode, means it is positive, it is negative. So these rays are moves towards anode, means negative to positive. That means these rays consist of some particle which is negatively charged. Second, I am explaining that this ray is negatively charged. This ray consists of particle, or that particle is electron. How I will prove this? If you put a moving wheel here, it will strike it and the wheel will start moving. That means it consists of particles. This ray also deflected in electric field towards positive electrode. That means, since these rays are bent, when you put a positive plate here, this ray will bend like this. It means this ray consists of negatively charged. That means this ray is deflected in electric field. As well as this ray also produces shadow when any obstacle is there. And here, if you change this cathode by various metals, various non-metals, that means this cathode, if you change, you will notice that same scintillation, that means same ray will produce from it. It means each and every substance consists of electron. It's okay? So like this, the electron was discovered. In cathode ray experiment also, it was found that the E by M means number of charge produced by the cathode and the mass of the cathode, it is always constant, and its value is 1.76 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kg. This thing you will learn in higher classes. And the charge of one electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And mass of one electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. I have noticed that sometimes this question will mainly come in the exam. What is the charge of an electron? It's okay. So this is all about your cathode ray experiment. Then we'll discuss about the proton, that is anode ray, then the discovery of neutron. After that, I will give the summary of this. Okay, out of which you will get number of MCQ questions. It's okay. Now you know that the electron was discovered by J.J. Thomson. After that, if there is a negative particle or negative subatomic particle is present inside the atom, then why positive particle is not present? Because you know that any substance is electrically neutral. If negative charge particle is there, there must be a positive charge particle. What is that particle? That is discovered by E. Goldstein. He repeated the same discharge tube experiment. But instead of plain anode, he has taken perforated anode or porous anode. And instead of taking that tube as vacuum, he took hydrogen gas inside it. After that, when he applied 10,000 volt or more than 10,000 volt, you have noticed that the beam of rays are coming from anode towards cathode in a parallel ray. These are in parallel form. Therefore, it is also known as canal ray also. Canal ray or anode ray, these consist of proton. So, E. Goldstein discovered the proton. Why E. Goldstein took hydrogen gas? Just listen to me. You know that hydrogen is one atom. We will discuss it later on when we discuss the atomic number and atomic mass. So, hydrogen atom, it consists of one proton and one electron. It has no neutron actually. Therefore, its mass is 1 and atomic number is 1. So, if it lose one electron, in that case, it will form H plus ion. Means this is known as proton. We'll discuss number of questions also like this. Acids are proton donor because it liberates H plus ion. H plus ion means it is proton. So, when in discharge tube took the hydrogen gas, it will form H plus ion and turns to proton. It's okay? So H plus ion mainly represented as proton. This is discovered by E. Goldstein. And the third fundamental particle, that is neutron, which is discovered by James Chadwick. Till now we know that atom consists of electron and proton. We'll discuss the mass of electron and proton also. But after that it was found that the mass is little bit high. This is due to the presence of another subatomic particle which is known as neutron. It is discovered by James Chadwick. Next, we will discuss about the properties of electron, proton, then neutron. So, electron is discovered by J.J. Thomson, proton is discovered by E. Goldstein, and neutron is discovered by James Chadwick. So, this is the first point. Second, the mass of the electron, it is almost negligible because it is 1 by 1836 or in some book it is written as 1 by 1840. So, its mass is 1 by 1840 times mass of proton, and proton mass is almost, that is 1 U, one unified mass. In third chapter you have noticed that 1 AMU, atomic mass unit or unified mass, and mass of neutron is almost same to the proton, that is also 1 U. So, comparative to proton and neutron, electron mass is almost negligible. Next point, charge of the electron and charge of proton almost same, but opposite to each other. This is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Magnitude of charge of electron is this much, but actually it is negative. But in case of proton, it is positive, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And charge of neutron, it is chargeless, no charge. It is no charge. Electrons are mainly rotate around the nucleus. One nucleus is there at the center of the atom. This is discovered by Rutherford. So, proton and neutron both are lie inside the nucleus. But electron lie outside the nucleus. It revolve around the nucleus in specified orbit.